Hi everyone, this is Jenny Lee with DigiStitches.com and thank you for joining us today. I wanted to talk to you today about creative packaging and how it can increase your business and how it can create loyal customers. I know some of you have attended my class at the Applique Getaway and may have already seen this demonstration, but I want you to stay tuned because I'm going to show you a technique of folding a t-shirt for packaging, and that technique is different from the one that we use on YouTube that shows you how to fold a t-shirt for photography. So stay tuned because I want to show you that. And I also think that you can pick up just a few extra hints and tips to increase your business. Now, if you don't have a business, hints and tips such as these can help you just create clever and creative packaging just for gift giving. You know, if you have a nephew that's having a fourth birthday and you want to package it in a special way to make him feel even more special, this can help you with that too. So I know that there are businesses, big retailers, that spend millions of dollars on their packaging techniques. And really, it's because it does create repeat business. And it is much easier to keep a customer that you already have than it is to go out and find a new customer. So let's learn how creative packaging can keep those customers coming back to your website and how the things that we're going to put into this package keep your customer thinking about you on a daily basis. All right, so first I want to show you just a little demonstration because I want you to actually see the difference. Now, some people just take, you know, recycled bags, or maybe they're buying new bags that say thank you on them, and just go ahead and put their t-shirt in a bag like this and give it to their customer like this. And I just don't think this is a very creative or clever way to give this to somebody. In fact, if I were a customer, I'd be thinking I can get maybe not your same quality t-shirt, but a t-shirt that's an applique t-shirt or a screen printed t-shirt from a discount retailer, and they're going to package the bag or package it just very similar to this. And it just doesn't feel, I don't know, it's just not all that special. So then I know some others are actually packaging theirs in bread bags that you get at the grocery store or using Ziploc bags. And it's surely a way to keep the rain off of your shirt if there's inclement weather when you're shipping. But again, it just doesn't feel all that creative, and it just doesn't feel all that boutique, and it doesn't feel all that special to me. So let me show you first how we're going to fold this t-shirt. This is something that I learned from Teresa. She used to work at The Gap, and this is how The Gap used to fold their t-shirts. So what we're going to do is start with a freshly ironed t-shirt, and then we're going to fold the sides in like this. Now, this is a short sleeve t-shirt. If you're working with a long sleeve t-shirt, you want to make a little fold like this so that the sleeves are going down this way along the t-shirt. But since this is short sleeve, I'm just going to fold it straight across. Then we're going to fold the other side in like this. Then we're going to fold the top down. And then we're going to fold the bottom up. Now, when we fold the bottom up, we're going to gently open up the collar of the shirt and put the t-shirt inside the collar like this. Now, from the front, it gives us a nice square, pleasing fold. And the best thing about this is when you pick it up, it stays all together. So this ensures that your shirt is going to stay packaged and folded nicely when you ship it to your customer, when you give it to your customer. So then what we're going to do is put our t-shirt in a bag. Now, these are double drawstrings bags that I purchased from Uline. They're about 8 cents a piece, and the price of the bags depends on how many you order. Obviously, there's a bulk discount, and I usually order in bulk. So these are about 8 cents a piece. These are the 9x12 size bags. These size bags work good for youth size clothing, onesies. If you're going to be packaging bulkier items like sweatshirts or adult items, you're going to want to upsize to the 10x15 bag. So Teresa's idea, she loves crinkle paper, and she thinks that it gives a really pretty pop of color to the bag, and I agree it does. And you can get crinkle paper at any party store. You can order it online from orientaltrading.com. They sell a 40-pound box of crinkle paper. So it makes it relatively inexpensive. So Teresa puts her crinkle paper in the bottom of her bag. And then we're going to take the t-shirt and put it into the bag. All right. Now, Teresa, and I don't know if I told you this at the beginning, Teresa has a master's degree in entrepreneurial management. So she really puts a lot of thought in into how to make businesses successful. So Teresa's business was called the Duck and Drake. So what Teresa did was get a hold of rubber duckies, and she got these from Oriental Trading. They're not that expensive, and they come in all different kinds of themes, and they make them for holidays too. So they might have pirate ones and race car ones and holiday rubber duckies for St. Patrick's or whatever. So she would put a rubber ducky into the package, and what she thought was great about this is that not only does your customer receive the t-shirt, but they get a little special gift for their child. And every time their child plays with this duck, maybe in the bathtub, they're going to think about Teresa's business. And that creates loyal customers and repeat business. So for my business, I have a lot of friends that tell me that they can hear my smile coming through when I talk. I smile a lot. I have a bubbly personality. And so I chose the smiley face balls for mine. These were about 25 cents through Oriental Trading when I ordered in bulk. If I went to the party store and got them, just in a smaller package of 20, they were about 50 cents each. So I'm going to go ahead and put that into the bag. And then I wanted to take the idea just a bit further, and I went ahead and ordered pens with my logo on them. And these come from 4imprint.com. They're about 13 cents each. And again, you get a price break when you order them in bulk. The more you order, the better the price is. But these are nice quality pens. In fact, I have customers tell me that they're their favorite pens, and so they're always emailing me asking me for more. But really, the only place you can get them is at the Applique Getaway in Texas. So I use the same color green that I have for my website. Everything in my website is green and blue. Those are just kind of my logo colors. And then they put my logo right here on it, which is Digi Stitches. And the great thing about this is every time your customer is using this pen, and they might use it daily, they are subconsciously thinking about your business. And that's what you want them to do. When they go to order their next t-shirt or next hair bow or whatever that it is that you sell, they are going to think about your business. And because your business is at the forefront of their mind, they are going to think of your business first when they want to order something. So we're going to go ahead and put that into the bag. And then I had some stickers made up. These are glossy stickers. They're high quality glossy. I purchased these locally, but I'll give you a link to who I purchased them from. I don't know if I told you the pens were 13 cents each. If I didn't, I apologize for that. But the labels say, look what I got from Digi Stitches, and they have my website address on them. And they also feature the same colors in the background that I use on my website. These are 17 cents each, and I will give you a link for ordering those. So I'm just going to peel off the sticky on it and go ahead and put that on the bag like that. All right, so when the sticker is on, I'm going to go ahead and close the bag. Now, I had some business cards made up, and these are in the shape of a gift tag. They actually print the business card up, and then they have a die cutter that cuts the template for the dog-eared corners and the little punch hole. These end up being about, I believe, 11 cents each. It's a little bit less expensive if you do the cutting of the corners and the little punch tag yourself, but I thought it was well worth the upgrade price to go ahead and have them do it. One less thing for me to do. So this has the same background that I have on my website. It has my logo, which is Digi Stitches. It has my website address. It says stylish, fun, and affordable appliques and machine embroidery designs, because that's what I sell. And I don't know if many of you know that, but I don't sell t-shirts. I sell machine embroidery designs and appliques. So that's what I want on my business cards. Now, on the other side, this says to and from, and I go ahead and leave those blank. And the reason I do this is because if you ship this to a customer, they might be using it as a gift, and they can use this as a little gift tag. And what else is nice about it is if they have something to order and they're in a hurry, they could actually have you send this to their gift recipient. Maybe their nephew is having a fourth birthday party, or maybe their niece is having a special occasion that she wants a t-shirt for. And she can send this, your customer can send this as a gift, and fill in the you can fill in the to and from for them, and then just ship that directly to their gift recipient. So we're going to go ahead and put this on the bag. All right. So then I think this is a really exciting package. I think if I received this in the mail, I'd be excited to open it. I feel like this was a really high quality product, and the person who made it put a lot of time and effort into it. And I got two little gifts with it that I didn't even order. And how fun is that to get something extra special and extra fun? I think it's really fun. And if you compare it with, you know, the first bag that I showed you, which is just the Ziploc bag, I just think that this is the clear choice for one that you would want to send to your customer. All right, I hope you learned something today. I hope the takeaway from this is something that will help you increase your business or just help you increase your creativity. If you'd like to see more videos like this, please follow us on Twitter or Facebook. You can find us at facebook.com/digistitches. You can also sign up for our newsletter on our website at digistitches.com. And we also have a YouTube channel that you can find under digistitches.com. Again, thank you for joining us today. I hope you have a great weekend, and I hope to see you next week for another informative video. We'll see you soon. Bye.